Hello everyone, welcome back to the workshop as usual. Today we're going to be building up two kits in one video. This full build series will be about Revell's 1/32nd scale semi-trailers. I know some of you had asked, I built a few of those tractors, the actual semi-tractors, and people were wondering if there were trailers available. ModelRoundup.com got in stock from Revell USA two of the 1/32nd scale trailers. We're going to build them both up so you have something to put with those very easy to build yet great looking 32nd scale rigs. These take up a lot less shelf space. They are beautifully detailed and go together quite easily, just as easily as the semi tractors. So we'll start taking a look at the first one here. This is the 40-foot Fruoff tanker. It's going to align with any of the 32nd scale rigs that Revell makes. It is a nice looking trailer there. You can paint it up in any options you want. We can see the great looking box art on there. They did a white with a metallic chassis. You can do the white with the red underneath it. I mean, you've really got a lot of options on there. Decide how you want to build it when you get it all put together. So let's take a look at inside the box. This thing has 46 parts in it, and we will take a look at what's going to be in there. First up, we might as well get the biggest parts out on the table. The entire trailer builds up to just over 15 inches long. You can see the massive size of this tanker. It definitely looks like a modern style tanker, not the older styles that I've built on the show in 1/25th scale. And these halves, obviously, are mirrors of each other. Make sure to cut these off if you're wondering why your trailer won't go together. These are actually sprue mounting tabs. Just take your sprue cutter from the opposite end, don't cut this tab off, and snip those off, and then things will go together much easier for you. But they should align like so. We'll get it to go. Takes a little bit of fiddling, especially with those nubs on there. But you'll see how everything will line up. We'll get that together. Now, I think these may be somewhat of a snap kit. It doesn't say anything on the box here that I read, but it should go together relatively easy, and we'll do all that on camera, of course. And you can use glue to reinforce any joints you want. On this one here, we've got the roof and all the fill caps for the trailer. We got hookups here, all these neat little fill caps we can detail. We've got our lines and hoses, trailer tanks, we've got standoffs, could be the toolboxes here, like so. We've got our toolboxes here, we've got the front of the trailer with all the hookups. That's interesting. Some of this, it almost looks like it has as much detail as a much larger 1/25th scale kit. We've got this long part here, we've got our frame. Mine has some warpage to it, very evident on mine. Should be gluing this to the bottom of the tanker anyways, so we shouldn't have to worry about it too much. It comes in two pieces. This is not part of the frame. This is the frame alone. And then we've got this section you can see where maybe it's supposed to have that arc to it. I could be wrong, and it should have that. Got part of our axles, walkway. At least that's what I think it is right now. I haven't opened up the manual yet. We've got fenders for either side, so they're separate. We've got our frames and our suspension. We've got our landing gear. We've got our axles and brakes all as one piece. That's pretty cool. We've got some of our valving and caps there. And then even though it's 32nd scale, we've got some small detail on there. Some small parts we can take a look at. Now we'll switch to the other side. There isn't a lot to go over on the other side of the table. There isn't a ton of multimedia. We've got black plastic tires, which actually look good if you paint them with flat black or a pavement color spray paint. We've got our ladder, and this is our mud flaps off the back. That looks like our kingpin to go into the semi-tractor fifth wheel. And these are branded tires. They're Union rubber. Then finally, we've got a nice decal sheet on this one. Canadian premium, American premium, all depends on what kind of trailer you want to do. We've got American flags, Canadian flags, we've got all the modern striping, we've got reflectives on the back, we've got all of our gallon readings on the side, and we've got them in metric as well. So that is pretty sweet. I like the detail on there. American Premium, Canadian Premium, all the Danger, all the Hazmat logos. Pretty neat. So that's all the parts in that one. Let me grab the other trailer. We'll get the parts out for that. We'll take a look at it. Then we'll start putting things together. It's going to be a series of 40-foot trailers today. Two trailers, one video. This is Revell USA's Fruoff 40-foot reefer. It's got a Thermo King refrigeration unit on the front of the Fruoff trailer. It is in the ice cream, and I love that logo. We know that logo from everywhere. So we got some cool decals to look forward to. This box says there is 48 parts, a whole two more parts. This is available from modelroundup.com as we speak. Let me start grabbing the parts on this one. This one is completely different, obviously, because it is a reefer. So it's a completely different style trailer. This is our floor. You can see the bottom of it. Definite push fit kit. You can just tell by the fittings, but I like to use glue on mine too, so they don't fall apart later. That's where our kingpin will go. Looks like these trailers were made around 1980, which, it doesn't sound that long ago, but it's 43 years ago. So it's a nice trailer bottom there. What else we got going on? We've got on this side of the table, we've got the axles and the brakes on that one. Love the wheels on this one. Old style five-star wheels. We've got rear doors, and the detail for all the latching mechanisms is quite prominent. And the hinges and the frame. So you can get a lot of detail in on that with a chrome pen, with a silver marker, anything you wanted to make that look authentic. I don't like it when it's too shallow and you can't use it. We've got some more suspension and frame rails. Nice detail on there. And I'm glad they didn't use the exact same stuff on both kits. They used some similar things, but not the exact same. Looks like we've got our Select-A-Point frame. So maybe this one has a sliding axle. Oh yeah, see? Select-A-Point, so you can slide the axle forward and rear. Got part of our landing gear supports on there. And on this one, we've got a separate reefer unit that will attach. We got the fuel tank on this one. There's 25th scale kits that don't even have a fuel tank for the reefer. Landing gear points. And check this out. No frustrating builds on this. It's all one large molded piece. It can just be injected like that. This is really awesome. Check out, don't cut these tabs off. This is how our floor is going to lock into place. So leave those on there. We got awesome rivet detail, which in scale, we'll see if we can get it close with that light. See the reflection off there? Nice detail on that trailer. Sits like so. We got the front where we'll be mounting that reefer. If you just wanted to have it as a standard trailer, just fill that in with some styrene. And you can have a regular trailer. Our doors will go on the back. We've got our lights molded in, the clearance lights on the top. A touch of silver with a little touch of orange or red, depending on where the light is, will suit you just fine. So that's all those parts. Let me switch to the other side of the desk. On the other side of the desk, we've got those Union tires in black plastic. Each one's molded in half. We've got the grill for the reefer. We've got separate mud flaps, and we've got a control panel with gauges. That's cool. And then check it out. Check out the decal sheet on this lovely little lady. Love those logos. We've got the blue and red striping. We got the Fruoff Long Ranger. Sounds like a dirty movie. Long Ranger. Thermo King, Fruoff logos on the side. We've got wide right turns. We've got turn logos on there. We've got the American flag, the Canadian flag, more polar ice details. We got the number 40, let you know how long the trailer is. We've got our reflectors, modern style reflectors for along the frame. So we've got a nice kit in this too. Now, in this next session, I'm going to start off building the tanker, then I'm going to assemble what I can on the reefer, and then we'll come back to look at those assembled parts.
Thank you.
Okay, Peeperinos, as you saw, super easy to work on this kit. Not hard at all. Easy to put things together. The most difficult part of it is deciding what to leave on the trees to get painted in various colors that I want to paint. So on the tanker here that we assembled first, I could tell that the chassis, yes, was a little warped, but it shouldn't be a big issue because it locks in positively to the tanker body. And then it follows the natural curve where it comes down to the lowest point here. So it was a little warped, but it's not really bad because the tank itself has this curve to it. It was a little exaggerated on the frame, but once it snaps in, it will hold itself perfectly. So nothing to worry about at all. The tank goes together lovely. You can see, and those are the seams in the front where it matters because everything else is covered. The bottom's covered with structure and the top is covered with structure. So that's it. You really can't even see those. You'll be able to see a crease when we paint it and stuff like that, but that's not going to matter. This is the bottom. It's got that natural curve to it, and the frame will just fit right up in there and not have any sort of an issue. We've got the front of the frame there for the trailer with the kingpin on it. That will, of course, attach all the way up here when we get to that point. We have our accessory toolboxes, or lock boxes, whatever you want to put in there. We got the ladder. I left the parts tree on here so I can paint that up. We got our axles for this one, which will just lock into the body as well, with our little air tank and everything on there. And you saw how that went together. That was pretty interesting how they had that and get that detailed of a piece. So that's it for the tanker assembly. The reefer was even easier because there's no big giant frame to put underneath it. The hardest part of the reefer assembly was pushing that kingpin in. And then we'll get this painted, just very basic. It's on the bottom of the trailer, so I'm not going to worry about it. And I did pre-attach the taillights. I want those on there solidly, and I want to paint those with the same colors that I'm going to use at the bottom of the trailer. Then we've got the fuel tank for the reefer. Goes together. That'll just press up into the bottom. We've got our landing gear, which is cool on this one that I can do them completely separate with our crank for them and everything. And then they give you options for the landing gear up or down with those feet on there that you can interchange. So we'll get that all painted up together. Then we've got the axle on the back. I attach the mud flaps because I want this all the same color anyways. That'll hold it together. We got our side rails. The other rails that will go and attach to the bottom of the trailer will paint separately so that we can capture the I-beams here so that the axle will float forward and back when we do our final assemblies. So literally, folks, this is as easy as it gets to assemble these type of kits. With 1/25th scale, you'd have a lot more parts. You'd be doing a lot more work. So we've got stuff over on the side that I've detached. We've got like this pipeline here that I put the ends on. Left a little bit of the tree. I can always touch that up with a marker or some painted paint from the can. Just squirt it in a little cup and paint it on there by hand when I'm done. But this gives me something to hold on to so I can get the entire part painted. We've got that big walkway across the top that I don't want the same color as the tanker itself. We've got the fenders for the tanker, the valves, some grab handles. Again, I don't want those the same color as the frame, nor the tank itself. And then we've got this underbelly. This actually goes, it's a ramp goes on top of the fender. We can see by our box art here. And I don't want that the same color as the frame. We got our wheels. We got this pipe on the side. All that interesting stuff. We got all kinds of cool stuff. Then on the reefer trailer, we've got the two rails for the select-a-point, the pin, and then we've got our landing gear here. So all of that stuff is on there. We've got the doors separate so I can get those painted up separately and then attach them. They have very large pins. We'll be able to paint everything up and then attach the bottom of that trailer as we go. And then here's the very front of the tanker trailer that, again, I want to paint the same color as the frame. That's it. I'm going to wash these very large pieces, the reefer, the tank, the refrigeration unit. I'm going to wash those in some dish soap or Simple Green degreaser. Get everything on there so that the paint doesn't fisheye or bubble up on those large pieces. When that dries, I will start throwing some paint at it, and I will see you over there.
Thank you. Thank you.
And since these kits are so easy to assemble, I figure we wouldn't stop and show you what I was working on. I would just continue going all the way through, show you the decals going on each trailer and all that. I didn't do any weathering on these. I just wanted to build nice models. And you don't have to weather yours or make them super street accurate or do anything like that. Build them the way you want. And if you want to weather some kits, that doesn't mean you have to weather every single kit. And if you want to build nice and shiny model on the shelf, you don't have to build every single kit that way either. There is what's called build it your own way. I know it's a hard concept for a lot of people out in the model world to understand, but that's what I like to do. So these I just built right from the box. I painted them, I decaled them, I pressed the final pieces together. That's what's nice about these. And when you're done, you do not have a weird looking kit. This does not look like a press fit kit. It looks like a beautiful trailer. It builds up easily. The decals lay down beautifully. Something you must know about these Revell decals is that they have to be left in warm water for substantially longer than decals from other companies. I had to let these guys soak, especially the large polar ice and the stripes. They must have soaked in hot tap water, not boiled water or anything, just hot tap water, for probably 4 minutes. Then I took them out, let them sit, and then finally they slid off nice and easily. As you see, they are large, so I use a towel to compress the water out of them. No decal solvent was used, not a drop, nothing. Just laid them down as they were and let them dry overnight, and they came out beautifully. There are no Thermo King logos for the reefer itself, but they are on the side of the trailer. I like that look. I went with the American style trailer with the polar ice on the back, and on the sides I used the Texas license plates, used the decals on the mud flaps, and everything went down beautifully. I didn't have any issues with the final fits on this. I love how the bottom attaches and the way they are able to inject the entire trailer. And even though they did it with a little bit of masking for the framework on it, it looks awesome, and there wasn't a long, complex assembly stage. They could do a modern 1/25th scale trailer the exact same way. They could inject it as a multi-sided box, leave the doors and all that, and the doors will open and close easily. I don't know if I can do it and leave it on the stand, but it's going to come off there. The doors do open and close. There's nothing to really see on the inside, so I guess we can leave it. It's going to fall off the stand anyways. But the doors do pop open and close. They install super easy. You saw me put them on. It's not this complex process with some of the 1/25th trailers where they work, they half work, they don't work. It just all comes out easily without a problem. So I'm going to have the tanker trailer up next. I just wanted to do intros of these. I don't have a big enough bench. And I don't have I can't set the camera back 20 feet or you're never going to see anything. So goes together super easy. I will link in the description where the reefer trailer is available. I will have pictures at the end of the video, and now we'll get the tanker up. And now we've got the tanker truck, which you don't see a lot of these. Normally, all you really see out on the market is the chrome tanker from AMT, which builds into a beautiful kit. Now we've got one in 1/32nd scale. These have been out for quite a while, and they've reissued them. This one with the American premium, Canadian premium fuel logos. We got the nice ladder I've hand painted with the mud flaps. The decals on this one drop just as easily, and they do take a while to come loose as well. Though the decals on this one are not nearly as large, so the reflective striping on the side of the tank comes off much quicker. The American premium logos do come off. I only had to leave those in for about 2 minutes or so to get those to release. The final assemblies are beautiful on this, no problems at all. I did end up tweaking these handles outward, and I left them. It was just a mistake, but they should be straight up and down, but outward kind of looks interesting too. Used a combination of metallics and regular spray paints. I wanted to duplicate that red trailer on the box art, the ones that are probably built by Bob. He did it with a metal frame. I wanted to do the red. I like the box art look with the chromed out fenders, and then the metallic runner. On the box art up there, it is done in the same color as the trailer, but I thought I just wanted it to stand out a little different and have that metal walkway, you know, the corrugated metal walkway on the top with all the nice chrome piping. We can see it in the mirror there, and the chrome wheels and the chrome fenders. I figure, you know, they're more duplicate like an aluminum look and a stainless steel look or whatever, but I like that how they look on there, and then I metallicize the handles on the toolboxes and all that, just to make it look a little different, to make it my trailer. Final assemblies went without a fight at all. The fenders snap on, the axle snaps into place. This axle does not move at all. It moves on the reefer forward and back as much as you need it to. On this one, of course, it is a solid placement. We've got all of our capacity indicators along the side. We've got our warning labels and our product label on the back. We got all the warning placards. Just love them. And these kits are easy. These could be first-time kits. You can grab the 1/32nd scale semi-tractors from modelroundup.com, grab the trailers, and have some interchangeable stuff going on. You will have a nice time, and anyone can build these. Simple paints, spray paints, the parts are individual, so you can spray paint them and then snap them together later, and they look great. They look every bit of a beautiful scale model as any glue kit, and you can see the seam is still there on the front and back, but that's it. So if you wanted to fill that, that's fine. Everything else is completely covered by structure on the trailer. And I think they look gorgeous as are. You really can't even see the one on the back because of the ladder. If you can see the seam on the front, you're looking pretty hard, but it wouldn't be a hard deal to fill that in if you wanted to fill that seam. You can kind of see it on camera as it goes around. So I want to thank ModelRoundup.com for sending both of these over for a 2-in-1 video build. I enjoyed them. They're nice slump breakers. You can get back to work on stuff real easy. You could, of course, enhance these with even more details and trailer hookups or whatever you wanted and just have an absolute blast, or build from the box. Do what you want with them. They're your kits. I will link in the description where you can snag both. They are in stock right now at Model Roundup, and I will see all of you at the next review.